Morning, everybody. Jangro here. Welcome to Sticky Piston TV and this Valhelsia Enhanced Vanilla stream. Good to see you guys. Hello, C3PO. Hey, Calidor. Thanks for coming by, as always. We are going to get started again in Valhelsia Enhanced Vanilla. Let's switch over to the game here. Well, I appreciate that, Calidor. How are you guys today? I was going to say this morning, but I don't think it's morning for everybody. Oh, you're going to test me on how to say Cox. Oh, that name. I'm doing well. Thank you very much. I have been... Yeah, me too, Calidor. It's been a couple weeks for me. I don't know if I mentioned it last week, because this was the situation last week as well. What time is it? Oh, it's morning, but it's raining. Before we get into a story, let's get our bearings. I have not been in here since last week. Part of me wants to come in and kind of set things up so it's a little more interesting. Part of me wants to just do an entire stream, this game on a stream only. And that's what I've been doing so far. Let's see. We've got the chickens for our XP. Let's keep them breeding and dying. So I post this video on Saturday mornings on my YouTube channel, and somebody commented that it was just too stressful watching. I don't think they like couldn't watch, but it was stressful because I'm running around with three hearts in hardcore, and that's stressful. And I agree. So I think what we should do. What I want to do is get myself some armor. If that's only leather. But also maybe just get our few more hearts in place so we can be a little less stressful. That's stressful for me too. Last time we made this copper pan farm with, what was it, four pans? Three pans. With three pans. But that's good for some stuff here. We got some clay balls to trade. So we'll get a mason going. Maybe we'll expand that copper pan farm a little bit. Oh, a tree just grew over my head. That'd be a tough way to die, drown in a tree. The other thing I want to do is get started on create, as I mentioned in the title. And to do that, though, we have to get... we need andesite. And it just occurred to me that we could steal... maybe there's some andesite. There's not very much. Okay. There's some... Those are all walls and stuff. That's useless. There's probably a little bit of andesite we can steal from the castle, which we've already robbed from and rebuilt. All that cobble you see there, we robbed and put back once we were a little more well off. And to get andesite, we already dug a stairway down. I wish I was able to sleep during this rain. We did run a stairway down here. But I don't think we found any andesite. So that's kind of the situation. We need to find some andesite so we can start on create. And we need to improve our survivability with armor and health. A shield. Stop raining. We also need to get control of our inventory. I am terrible with inventory and sorting, and if this is vanilla, I would be heading toward a big, giant redstone filter storage system, because I just am terrible at organizing chests. But we'll try to do that. We'll try to get some chest organization so we can know what we have, especially as we start on create. The sounds are a little loud. Let's fix that. Maybe I could turn myself up too. No, I'm up. Let's just turn the game down a little overall. See if that's better. I was thinking, rather than trying to funnel down, stare down, we could head down into this ravine. The easy way, not the folly way. So I feel like if we have a nice big walls to look at, we're going to find some andesite. Some, you know, maybe some like that right there. There's a difference. I don't know if that's gravel or what. So if we just kind of ease our way down there, I mean, it's not very safe, but that is a massive ravine, and I feel like that will be our key to finding. Look at that cave. That'll be our key to finding some andesite quickly. Of course, that comes with great risks. It's true. Falling is pretty easy. That would be the easy way down. Easy way to a new game in hardcore. Okay, let's do this. Eat, and then we'll make sure we are equipped with all of the caving things. Torches, pickaxes, shovels. Chubble 88, good morning. Thanks for joining us. We just did a recap of where we're at. So organization, because look at my inventory already. It's just, we're starting out with a mess. And a mason. We need a stone cutter for a mason. And for that, we need iron and stone. Oh, I have diamonds. That's right, from last time. Do I not have cobble? There we go. Got all these eggs. All right, we certainly have enough copper for pans. We wanted to make some more and expand that. That might actually be a smart thing to do at this point. Okay, we'll have a mason pretty soon. Is there a guy in here we can give a job to? These guys are all jobbed up. The fishermen are hard to remove their jobs because there's barrels everywhere. Bit of inventory cleanup here. Okay, Now we can make a... Oops, I already had that here. One. Can we make two? Let's make two of those. Eggs everywhere. We've got two stone cutters. Let's see who we can... Let's go to sleep. Okay, let's find someone, a few guys to turn into stone cutters. It would be best if we could trap them somewhere. It'd be a shame to take this poor guy away from his job, since he's got this specialized house. What else? Who else have we got? We could break this. Let's break this and see if it frees up anybody. There was a farmer in the castle. These are some cool buildings. For sure. I don't know, we don't have a heck of a lot of villagers to work with here. I thought we had more. Well, here they are. Here's some farmers. Okay. The thing about these guys, I think they have to see that their station's broken in order to remove their jobs. Oh, there's one right here. I bet it's his. Okay, there's a guy. Good. Let's put this here. What do you say? Want a new job? Looking at it. You guys are both looking at it. Come on. How about now? All right, we got a mason. Of course, I didn't bring any clay with me. Need a mason who will buy clay, which is like, you know, a 50-50 chance. It's the very first thing, so that's nice. Friend, what do you got? Of course, you're not buying clay. I don't want to hit you. Come over here. This would be better. It's not 50-50. Let's see. Ah, no. Don't step in the way. Oh, come on. Come back here. Of course, this is how it goes. This difficulty is usually reserved for librarians. There we go. Got 3 points. Now we can sell the emeralds back. Get a little more. Okay. Now this one's easy. We just go pick up clay balls. Okay, so we have enough defense for leather armor. We can get to shield use. I'm not the best shield user, although I feel like that might be a smart thing to do. Just to get a shield. We got to diamond tools. All right, it's all coming back to me now. We got to diamond tools level for mining, so we're done there. Although we did want to upgrade farming so we could at least use some better iron. Gold is nice. Okay, we are at iron. All right, let's do this. Let's give ourselves our best chance to survive here. Let's go with health. Let's put this other one down in case we get another guy. There is another. Thought there was. Yeah, you. You want it. No, you do. Go get it. Let's go get another clay ball in case he switches over. And we'll get 2 masons. We'll work on expanding this copper pan farm. Because clay balls is truly the path to some nice easy XP in this mod pack, but in general as well. You're just gonna keep standing there? Here, let me help you out. Somehow, he couldn't get down the stairs. Alright. Good deal. Alright, we got 2 masons locked in. Now, let's do this. Let's trap these guys here. We'll use some of these chiseled stone bricks. Can't put that there. There's too much going on here to trap them easily with. Let's see. We can put a kind of villager proof. Some carpet. That's not carpet. That's carpet. Gonna come in? Who's gonna remain? There. That will keep them here. Are the masons here? Yeah. Alright. Next step, a little bit more organization, I guess. So we've got some zinc. That's good for Jay Carmichael. Good morning from Idaho. Or to Idaho. From Colorado. Practically neighbors. Get some more food going. You don't have string. I don't think. That's going to be what we need to make some more copper pans. Let's start shifting things around here a little bit. Make a few more chests. Lock the windows. Pretty well set for a pickaxe right now. Oh, my chest in the ceiling. I'll continue to put chests up there, probably. Let's sleep. I much prefer barrels, but we're in a village and that's just going to be a constant battle with fishermen. So, food. Let's make this our food. Make this our food chest. And we'll put blocks in this one. Those out of there. People always ask me how I'm sorting because it's not obvious, but I'm pressing on the mouse button, mouse scroll wheel, and it sorts the chest you're in or your inventory. I put cooked chicken in here. Good job. Food. Seeds in here too. Block, block. Yeah, eggs is a problem. All right, good tip about the chest on the ceiling. I mean, eventually we're going to get to applied energistics and chests will become completely obsolete, which is why I just never bother sorting. Hopefully we'll be able to get to applied energistics relatively soon. In this mod pack, which is Valhelsia Enhanced Vanilla, there's a couple big mods. Tech Reborn, Applied Energistics to create. Those are kind of the big ones. And I want to get started on create, and I always want to get to applied energistics as quickly as I can for sorting and auto-crafting. I might hold back on Tech Reborn. Let's see about that. Maybe just do kind of a focus on create or automating and doing all the things. A little more interesting than a bunch of machines. We need some torches. Make this our ores chest. Ores and materials like that. need a better shovel. And a new axe. Getting myself ready to head down into that ravine. It's kind of where my head's at right now. So here's a shovel. And an axe. And 2x2s. I think that's what you meant. Yeah, I usually, if I'm gonna be living with these lines of trees, what I do is put a row of slabs, I think about 7 blocks high, over the trunks, and then they won't grow big. And we can just keep it contained like that. Waiting for some stuff to fall so we can replant this. In this pack, though, diamond axes do whole tree cutting. So that's where we're hoping to get soon. I need level 14 farming to use a diamond axe, however. Which is why we want to get to diamond, though, as quickly as possible. Alright, did I have coal anywhere? I need some. I can cook some logs, I guess. But I already converted them. Any coal. Organize a little bit better here. Oh, Rose gold does the whole tree cutting too, apparently. I have not even done anything with rose gold. That was added pretty late to the pack. More eggs. Stupid eggs with their 16 stacking. Alright, I don't have any logs to make charcoal. I don't have any coal, apparently. I don't know why. And I did get a few saplings. All right, if I find some gold tools, I mean, I could just make some rose gold. I've got copper, I've got gold. Let's try it. Let's do it. Because we've got lots of copper. Was there a smithing table around? A smithing table. Thanks, Jay Carmichael. Yeah, I was. I forgot how to say your name. Coxch. Coachk. Remember, we like went through it for 10 minutes 4 or 5 weeks ago. Smithing table. Easy. Smithing table. Let's put it here. And he's smithing one to use a smithing table. So there's a barrier. Okay, how are we doing for? Let's do this. Let's go harvest, feed the chickens and the cows. I know it's not right. Anything in here? Nope. Okay, back to bed. Here, give me the phonetic spelling of your name. I'll try to remember it this time. That was like Cox and then Ch. Cox chicks. Okay, feed the animals. Kill the animals. So the this mod pack has been updated since last week, and I have not had time to update it. Which was where I was going to start. This is what I was going to start telling you about at the beginning. Some real life stuff. Just haven't had time to do much of anything. But there's a new version of the mod pack, which they removed the mod that makes chickens reproduce when they're sitting on hay bales with their eggs hatching. So that's kind of sad. So as soon as I update, that is going to go away, where their eggs turn into more chickens when they despawn. Coaxch. Got it. Okay, we've gotten a level for our smithing. The baby get out of there. Get back in there. Okay, now we can upgrade the smithing. Yeah, a gold axe. Turn it into rose gold. little bit. Yeah, they're glitching through the fence. Now we can make a gold axe. I can't use gold axes either. Darn it. Rose gold I need. I know, Chubble, I know. Sirhat, good day. Rose gold I need level 9. Let's postpone that. Make do for now. Well, how are you doing? Okay, we're gonna have to go down into the ravine to find the coal. We've got plenty of sticks and some torches. There's weeds. Let's go see how we can make our way down into this ravine safely. Find some andesite and some coal. I'm from Colorado in the States. How about you? There's some coal. Let's head down this wall. Looks like that wall might go all the way down. We can stair way down and get some coal at the same time. Okay, so this needs to go. This is our target wall right here. Since we're talking about locations, reason I've been unable to do much Minecraft in the past couple weeks. Is that my family has a farm in Kansas. Very part-time, but when it's on, it's on. So, been spending the past couple weeks trying to get a crop planted. And that's just been consuming me. We grow things like wheat and sorghum and soybeans, and this was the sorghum crop that we were trying to get planted, and it was just a nightmare with mechanical issues. I've been down there the past 2 weekends for long weekends getting that done. We got it done on Sunday, so we get back to life now. Let's not forget to torch up the place. Yeah, go Avs. It is not my home state, so a huge Avs fan, although it is fun. Hockey fan. Hockey is my sport. Played. But I'm from Boston all my life until fairly recently, so I'm a Boston sports fan, which tends to cause reactions. Not in recent years, though. Things have settled down. Hey, Sam Nez. How are you today? Thanks for being here. We are working our way down into this ravine. Playing in hardcore, so I need to just do this slowly and carefully. And we need coal to torch things. But our goal is andesite. That is our... I'm doing very well, thanks. But anyway, to bring it all around full circle, when Kalidor said I'm tired, I'm exhausted from the farming. But I'm recovering. I did not want to get up this morning, though. How's Boston? So maybe you caught the tail end of that. I live in Colorado, so I can't do an up-to-the-minute report on Boston. But that's where I'm from, originally. Colorado's nice, of course. Oh, what's that? There's a... I can't zoom. I don't have Optifine in the zooming. Or a spyglass. That is a... some sort of little, like, campsite in... like a miner's camp or something. Definitely want to get down there. There might be a mimic down there, though, so that would ruin our day. Let's head in here. So before I go anywhere near, I forget how to identify a mimic, but I need an escape route, or just to box him in before I even go near it. Scotland, Sam, excellent. I've never been there. I would love to go there. No andesite yet. It's nighttime. I should have brought a bedroll. Let's just... if I go up there now, it's going to be a mess. Let's just keep down here and safe. Yeah, I would imagine Scotland's quite different from Colorado. Shovel. Can you tell if it's a mimic before you get to it? I can't remember. If I get trapped by a mimic, though, it usually is a mimic in those little camps. Andesite. It's hard to tell. Just gonna keep things torched. Whoa. Let's make this a little safer. Yes, thanks for the follow, Samnes. Let's continue down. Let's look out this way a little bit. See what we're dealing with. You like my accent? I have a suppressed Boston accent. So I don't know what that means. It sneaks out once in a while. Bean does not come over here. I grew up, my family, everybody were very much, I mean, my family's from Boston since like the Mayflower, but very strong Boston accents in my family. So, you know, all the movies you watch with the Matt Damons and the Boston accents, that's what I grew up in with my family. I never liked it. I think I was very self-conscious of it, you know, which in a way is sad, but, you know, they never left home to go anywhere. They were very, very much homies, and, you know, I went to college and got jobs dealing with people all over the country, all over the world. So I don't know, I was just kind of self-conscious of it, and stopped. But people are usually surprised that I'm from Boston. Yeah, Texas and the South, that's interesting. I hear a lot more Texas accents out here in Colorado now than I do Boston accents, that's for sure. Lost as to getting close to that chest. Make sure I know my way out. Quick escapes because of that. If that was a skeleton, that would have been bad. Seriously, that's the first monster I've killed? Let's not fall down there. Anyone sees andesite, shout. I will grab the zinc. That's what we need, zinc and andesite. Sapphire is good for some XP. Lapis. torches. Torches, not cobble. What is that? See that? Brick. Stone bricks? Okay, this is a change, and there's the camp. That seems to be a zombie spawner. That changes everything. We now have a spawner. So this is a structure, I think from Young's Better Dungeons. Light things up somehow. Down here carefully. Not get stuck up on. Let's light this up. Too much over torch. That should be good. I want those chests, but are they mimics? I'm not sure these are mimics, because that's a different mod. Landing my escape carefully and safely. It's probably painful to watch, because I'm just like way slow here. Eat. Light it up, light it up. There's slabs up there, they can't spawn on top. All right. Well, I know that. Oh, I'm scared. I'm scared of mimics. Quick escape route. Oh, wait a minute. There's two of them? There's a campfire over there and a campfire down there. This is just a dungeon, right? No mimics. I get attacked by a mimic, I can run. I'm gonna try this out. Run this way. They are so fast. And I am not. more safe. I'm being overcautious. Well, I think they would have. It's not opening them, right? Is it just okay? Okay. All right. Good. What do we got? Tech reborn machine frames and rubber saplings. Retreat. That's appropriate. Advanced alloy. That. Oh, glow sticks are cool too. A glow stick you throw and it lights up an area before you go in it. All right, what should we do now? We got a spawner. We should probably get that up to the surface. All right, let's find our way back out. So this way. The sink. I still haven't found andesite, by the way. But we've been distracted by a spawner, which we can now turn into a XP farm. Be fun to make an XP farm like with create belts and stuff rather than water. Is this our way out? It's a way out. I don't feel like this is how we came in though. I don't want to lose that. I don't want to lose that spawner. This is not how we came, but there's torches. I'm lost. And I hear a skeleton. How do we get out of here? This seems like a reasonable way out. I'll find my way back. Hey, Sounder Duke. It's going pretty well. We found that. Oh, here's the stairs up. Okay. It's right below that side. That's a zombie spawner down there. There's also a couple of mining camps down there. Not mine colonies, mine camps, but you know, just like a little campfire and chest. This doesn't have mine colonies in it. Grab a few more bits of things. We still need andesite. Is that our stairway out, or is this our stairway out? Did we not really make a good stairway? I don't know. I feel like we should get that. No, I just made a terrible staircase. Oh, I dug into the wall. That's why. I feel like we should go get that spawner and make an XP farm right below us. It could like stay there and be an XP farm. Actually, yeah, let's go. Sun's going down. Got a point. Put it on farming. I want to get to rose gold, which was level 9, I think. Hey, Dragon Slayer, the reason I only have 4 hearts is because, let's see, this mod pack is Valhelsia Enhanced Vanilla, and it has a mod in it called Level Z that has this skill system that you can see on my screen right now. You get when you hit the K button, and you need to level up these, 12 different skills. And I've leveled up to 3 in health, which means I have 8 hearts, which equates to 4 hearts on the bar. And you know, so that's why you start out with only 6, which is 3 hearts on the bar. And hardcore, that's not a requirement of the mod pack. That's just my stupidity. You know, so there's defense. You know, I can't wear armor until I level that up or use a shield. I can't mine things until I level up or use tools, but then what I can mine is also impacted by the level I'm on. So that's what this dangerous and dumb, yeah. I know. But it adds a little bit of tension. Adds a little tension to the game. We got some good stuff that trip. I'm hoarding my diamonds. That's not food. I'm gonna put the fishing these things in here. All right, we are going to take a very short break. I'm gonna get another cup of coffee since it's early here, and I'll be right back. Back again. Thanks for sticking with me for that quick break. Get some more coffee. So here we are, halfway through the stream. We found a spawner, a zombie spawner, which is lucky. A skeleton spawner. That would have been quite challenging with my 4 hearts and no armor to capture, but zombies are easy. What do you guys say we head down, grab that spawner, bring it to the surface? We can do that in this mod pack. Like, we can pick up mobs. We can also pick up chests and spawners in the same way. Let's do it. Since we don't have any andesite yet, that will give us a good way to get some XP. Have everything we need to do that. Food. Food's the most important thing. Because when you're carrying something, it really does a number on your food hunger. Bonner was, I have so many eggs because there's a, I just have a big chicken farm and they're just laying eggs and I walk by and that's my source of XP right now is chickens. Okay, so that spawner is like right below us. Let's go over there and just, whoa, let's go eyeball that. So I think I want to just build a nice easy stairway down there. Just like down there. Yep, it's right there. So if we head over, here and go this way. I don't know, was that like 40 blocks down? Maybe this far down. Let's just dig a stairway down. I want it to be daytime when I get it to the surface. So I can just safely put it down and then we can figure out what we're going to do with it. Hopefully I brought enough pickaxe. Could have been more scientific about locating that, but let's take a shot at it. I missed it by a little bit. Let's go down this way. Nice to find some andesite, though. I've heard people who have just had a terrible time finding andesite in this mod pack. There are entire pterolith biomes, andesite caves. Pterolith is a mod in this pack that dramatically changes the biomes. That's why I have that amazing village. Man, that's a long way down. Maybe I should have. Didn't do a great job triangulating on the spawner. We We need a nice, easy path out. Carrying a spawner is slow and dangerous. Let's see where we're at. Okay, we're close. Getting there. Let's go down this way. It's a little safer. Trying to figure out how to say that. Demacia run? Demacia rune? Alright, can I reach here and just build the stair? Yes, here we go. So for those of you who have just joined, we're playing Valhelsia Enhanced Vanilla, modded Minecraft. The thing about this mod pack is that it has a kind of an RPG feel to it, and you have to level up your skills in order to do things like use tools and get health. That's why I have such a low health bar. I'm like scared to jump down here. We can do that. So now we need to stair our way up here. Try to make things as safe for myself as possible. Okay, so we run up here with our, let's try it out. We run up here. Terrible too high stair. I destroyed my way out there from the coal. That's right. Go up this way. That's the surface. All right, let's grab it. Not sure what we're going to do with it, but we can get it up there, light it up, and then figure out what we're going to do. So we need an empty hand, two empty hands. Probably light this up a little so we don't meet. If we had to put the spawner down and it's dark, we're gonna have a fight. a death, probably. So let's not. Of course, it's nighttime. I'm going to come out. Let's do this during the day. See, there's the reason I have so many eggs. Fight going on over here. Okay, we're safe. Okay, let's go get that spawner. And then we'll come up with something fun to do with it. Everything's a project when you have 3 health, 4 health. No tanking ahead. Of course, I probably lost the stairway I just made, which is this way. Where was that? Okay, it wasn't this far. I'm an idiot. I lost it. Where is it? It's like... So I made it from here, right? And this way, not enough blocks. Dug down, here it is. Let's do this. Okay, empty hand. Let's go get it. Johannes, good morning. I'm doing well, how are you? Grinding to get this spawner to the surface. So a shift right click. And now we need to get to the surface before we starve. You just see my health, my food bar go down. But here I am carrying a spawner. Let's not walk in that lava. There's lava over here somewhere. There it is. All right, where should we build a... spawner, I mean a XP farm. put it up in the air or dig it out of the ground. But I need to eat. See, there's the danger of hardcore. Okay, that was close. Let's torch this up in case we just want to leave it here for a minute. What spawners can spawn mobs while you're carrying them if it's dark? No. Yeah, that's not. That's not true. I think they basically don't exist when you're carrying them. You know, as entities, so. Yeah, they do not. I've never had a mob spawn on me when I'm carrying them. Okay, we don't want to put it right here because we're going to expand our copper pan farm up that hill. I'm trying to think of something fun to do with it. Like, what if we put it up on top of that tower? Taco Live, thanks for the follow. Appreciate it. What if we put that... That would be kind of fun, right? You have to make it look good. In a 9x9, a 9x9 room up there would be, I don't know, that'd be kind of an eyesore. Hey, Nicey Live. Yeah, the shaders are complimentary shaders. They come with this mod pack. This is a fabric mod pack, not Forge. Therefore, it doesn't use Optifine, and therefore, the mod devs can ship shaders with a mod pack. If you didn't know, Optifine is not, does not have a license that allows distribution. So that is why mod pack developers don't generally ship shaders with their packs. I don't know. I don't think I want to put a giant 9x9 box on top of that tower. That would be ugly. How about over here? I just want to have it nearby so we can quickly and easily get to. I also don't want to build up in the air. Right, I don't want to build up in the air because I'm going to fall doing it. All right. Let's do this. Oh, it's down here. Okay, let's just put a... And let's also not just build it with cobble. All right. Okay, we're gonna put just a 9x9 vanilla mob farm kind of thing right there with our spawner. We'll make it out of bricks. Let's be civilized here. What do we got with just cobble? Can we make? Is there some sort of thing? We can get cobblestone bricks. Let's be lazy, but also civilized. And let's make it out of cobblestone bricks. That is still probably not enough, but let's start there. Let's frame this thing out. Weeds. Forgot about that hole. I need to do something about the grass situation. Johannes, did you notice they took the eggs hatch on hay bales mod? I haven't updated yet, so we're still getting chickens from our hay bale platform. As soon as I update, that is going to go away. Frame this out. We'll make it look nice. Cobble bricks are pretty cool, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then one on each end. So 11, right? You need 11 frame to get a 9x9. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Seven, eight, nine, 10. And these should match up. Okay. There's the, let's go to sleep. I wouldn't say they want to make it hard as possible, Calidor, but yeah, they definitely focus on balance. And it's kind of a loophole, right? You know, because of the skills, breeding is level 5 farming. You know, so if you can get around that with some technique, and if they can't block it, if that was a requirement that you know, level 5 breeding to do that technique, then they would have left it, I'm sure. Yeah, I mean, you could also just add it back in, you know, keep the pack updated and add it back in. No big deal. Yeah, I'm surprised they've left the feeding trough too, to be honest. But no. Hard to say. Some of the motivations for modpack devs. Hello, this is not Caleb. Thanks for being here. Build ourselves up to a death fall. Which means a bucket of water is necessary. surround ourselves with some water here. You put two bees by mistake. That's funny. This is gonna be, it's gonna be a little grindy for a stream to build this, but it is going to help us out quite a bit. Yeah, I can pretty that up for sure. Probably not even going to have enough cobblestone to do this. Noon. Okay, we have enough time for another round over here. I don't know, that cobble's pretty neat though. So we'll just do a vanilla mob grinder here. Hit XP farm. That's dangerous. Liam, thanks for the follow. How are you today? Yeah, early on it's pretty grindy, which the pack is. I don't know, but that's kind of why I like it. I like early game. I like starting new worlds, to be honest. What do we got here? So this is our floor. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We need 4 more rows on top. Three. We're gonna need more cobble. Right, because we are out. Let's switch to cobble deep slate at the top. Let's use up some of this. Let's do a row of that, because why not? Polished. Yeah, wood tools are pretty tough. But I don't know, you can get to stone and iron pretty quickly. You do have to manage to survive with low health for a while, though. All right, let's put a row of this, see how it looks. And then a row of this again. The cobblestone bricks goes well with that deep slate. Actually, it's got that darker gray in it. Pretty neat. Nighttime. Oh, just enough. Okay, let's. I'm scared to even jump. Let's jump here. Should just get a bedroll. Mason trays for cobble bricks, that might be an option. Pretty neat. We got a moire effect going on with the cobble. So I think we need two more, including the ceiling. I didn't trap the nitwit. He trapped himself. No, let's go get some. What we got here? Trade for some with some masons and see what building block we got now. No, they've got the olive stone and I don't know, it might be too ugly to mix. This guy's got the olive stone bricks and this guy's got the, where's the other mason? Chiseled stone bricks. Can I get enough? Thirty-two is not quite enough. Maybe we can cap it with the chiseled stone bricks. Let's go in here. Oh, we need a new pickaxe. Let's get, what do we have for materials? We can make another ruby pickaxe. Let's just do that for now. Continue to Or to the diamonds. Down, we'll just continue our mine shaft here just to get some more cobble. I forget if there was anything dangerous down here. Oh yeah, that was water through there. And it's all coming back to me. We dug down here. There's a mine shaft down here somewhere ahead of us. You can see on the mini map. But I don't want to be down this far. I need cobble, not deep slate. I should put stairs. It's all marble. Okay, let's... You know what? Let's just build a basement under the castle. Sorry, I ran all the way down there for that. But we just need some cobble. We'll carve up kind of a basement area up here. Let's do this right here. Good call on the roof. Put slabs for the roof. Of course, we find a cave. Distractions. This is a good distraction. Coal and XP. Is that my stairway I'm digging up into? Yeah, and if we slab the roof, we also don't have to light it up, so that's good. Man, there's a lot of coal. Point on farming, getting there. Yeah, things, Kalidor, things speed up a lot once you get to kind of level 6 mining, and you can get, you know, you can use iron tools, and you know, and then you can get XP from all the mining. Sapphire. Now we have enough sapphire for tools. we doing here? If I need two more rows, which is 11 by 11, just the perimeter. So a stack for that row and then slabs. This should be enough. I think we've got enough. That's the wrong chest. Yeah, we were going to do this stone bricks, but I don't think we can make slabs out of that. But the slab idea is way better than the stone brick idea. Oh, wrong button. We can. So we're going to need a stack of that. More than a stack. I think feel like this is enough without doing too much math. Let's organize a little bit while we wait for nighttime. Still not enough then. That's 84. I'm going to need more cobble. Thanks for doing some math for me. Oh, two stacks. That's enough. But now we don't have enough cobblestone bricks to do. Whites do the perimeter. What chiseled stone bricks in the corners? There we go. Oh, sleep. Make it work. C-3PO, is actually Bear coming on after me? Do you know? I'm going to put these chiseled stone bricks here. He did last week, and that was surprising, but I just wanted to make sure. Right, I think that is where we want to be. Slab. that one. These chiseled stone brick corners look good. We'll just do that all the way around. I mean, all the way down. Yeah, that's a good point, Johannes, about making the room a little bigger. I usually just kind of stick them in there anyway, even though it's not optimal. It's just enough anyway. I'm not one to min-max. Yep, figured that out by now. Storm. Great. Wild Maniac, how's it going? Thanks for coming by. Stuff the itch. Bargain for a thunderstorm in the middle of the day. But we can go see this. Yeah, I think they look pretty cool. Let's go check it out. Eh, I mean, it's pretty flat. Let's go sleep this thunderstorm. It's part of the mob farm. Need to dig down. Rainbow, nice. Let's not fall in here. Okay, so the floor, I think, is that one. Nope, it's not. Let's light this up a little bit so we don't have any incidents. Okay, now we need to dig down. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right here. One. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Do we have any caves under here? I don't think so. I need a way out. I'll stair my way up this direction. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Need a little kill chamber, nothing too fancy. Got some cool marble down here we can use. Kill chamber can have some nice white walls. All right, C3PO, thank you so much for your help as always. Appreciate it. Have a great day. I don't want to finish this, so I'm going to stick to this a bit. This mod does not have a quest book, Wild Maniac. It's mod pack, I should say. Not to correct you, but correcting myself. No quest book. So it's, you know, it's pretty, the the level system kind of gives you a reason to do things and move, you know, in certain directions. Ah, I'm drowning. Distractions. Alright, that was almost it. I got down to a half a heart. What a dummy. Anyway, no quest book. You know, leveling up and going in directions like that helps to give you some reasons to do things rather than being purely open world sandbox. Exactly, Johannes. That's what I was trying to say when I was busy dying. Shaken up by almost drowning, to be honest. That was kind of nerve-wracking. Okay. This is a decent sized kill room. We'll go get the things we need to finish that up. And then we'll move the... Where's the hole? We want to go south. Let's make our stairway... Well, we're going to want to go this... Why is this getting mossy? Is there more water behind here? You did those advancements, really? Eating all the edible food. Yeah, that's a good point. I mean, I've been playing this mod pack since December in the very beginning, and after I was already pretty well leveled up in my YouTube world, they added in the advancements to get skills. And yeah, I never really pursued those. Stairway this way. Let's do it. Let's do it in the center. Straight up. Love to get my hands on a totem of undying. Fortunately, taking on a big raid. Probably defeat the purpose. I am in a village though, so I'm probably going to trigger one accidentally. Some point. Okay, now we need some hoppers and chests. We've still got not enough slabs and some slabs. Polished deep slate slabs for the floor over the hoppers. We're going to need a bunch of iron here for our... hoppers. And some chests. Okay, let's get some more wood. Let's go to sleep. The guy really is trapped in there. That's funny. All right, we are close. We are so close to having her zombie farm. Which will carry us pretty well for a while with some nice easy XP. Size platform should we make? We'll start kind of low on iron. We'll just start with 4. Maybe 6 if we can pull it off. Hey, Nat Dino? Yeah, we can get 2 more. Two more hoppers. That XP does not give us level Z mod XP, so that stinks. Server for 8 people, I'd try 8 gigabytes for this mod pack. It's depends, you know. Everyone's gonna be on at once and exploring around and generating chunks. That probably will, you'll feel that. But you know, normal play and everyone's on, you know, only part of the number of people, I'd start with 8. Eight chests, hoppers, did not get slabs. Yeah, Sticky Piston is great. It's not just me saying that. Really is great. And, you know, RAM is RAM, but, you know, I think the machines that they're on are going to be better with Sticky Piston, so that helps. They're always there to help and give you some advice. Okay, so this was 21. We want them to land right here. So we're going to need to dig down a few more. And I think if we go down 21 and a half, that works. Put the hoppers like this. And the chest here. slabs here. Why do I only have five? Oh, because that's not the slab I'm using. I'm using this one. Hey Bird, 8675. This is the Valhelsia Enhanced Vanilla mod pack. So there's hundreds of mods. The main ones are Create Mod, which we started to go toward. However, we got distracted because we found a zombie spawner, and we're building a fun. They're gonna drop here. Them to be able to walk here. Applied Energistics. Thanks for the follow, by the way. Applied Energistics to Tech Reborn. Those are the big ones. But there's a ton of, you know, quality of life mods and everything. I'm making this six wide so the zombies can kind of spread out and not kill themselves with entity cramming. That's good. This should work. We can tweak it later. Let's get that zombie spawner in here. Right, no one's gonna escape that. That's just a half high. Dig this side a little lower so we can kill them better. Water. All right, we need to put water in the bottom. I should have tested the water before I dug the hole. We need a bucket. Got a bucket. Do it right. So far, so good. What happened here? Okay, so now we're going to want the spawner to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Up here. one more bucket. You're so close. But it's nighttime. Grab the spawner. I know, Johannes, I don't have a sleeping bag. I've got plenty of wool, I haven't done it. Not a very good example of how to play Minecraft. Let's just get that straight. Running around with no sleeping bag, or I don't think I need to do this, but let's just do that. No sleeping bag, no shield. Okay, so that is the... Yeah, that would be a great addition to vanilla. This is the entrance. That's kind of temporary blocks. Get our way over here. So we need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's gonna sit. One, two, three, four. Yep, it's gonna sit right here. We need, I'm going to just put blocks to the ceiling above it. We'll break the stuff from below, break the torches, and we'll be in business. Okay, here we go. Let's do this. Eat. Nobody can escape there. I've got one more bucket of water. Darken it up and not fall. That would probably kill me. Last bucket. Close it up. Missing. One more cobblestone brick. I don't know what happened to that. Okay, this should... Is this too much light right here? Did I figure it... Oh, there's a hole in the ceiling. No, there's not. It's just light creeping through. Oh no, there's a torch. Where was that? Here? There. Here they come. Oh, I didn't. They're probably underneath. I didn't wall off that little gap. But, okay, that's good. Close that off for now. I need to wall this. They don't catch a break. Now, did I do my digging math properly? Still alive? Oh, we need torches. Here we go. And stuff is going into the chest. All right, I just need an AFK spot. For business. Big Bad Buddha, thanks for coming. How are you today? I'm doing well. This is actually not smart because zombies will break a door in hardcore. Let's make an iron door. I don't even have enough iron, I don't think. I don't think I have 6 iron tucked away anywhere. Let's see. It's too bad you can't make copper doors or tin doors. Oh, we do have iron. Not sure it'll be enough. Let's see. Nuggets. Let's go trade this clay. Smith, that's not what we want. Where's everybody? No, buy andesite, not sell it. That'd be nice if they sold it. Some more iron nuggets in here, I think. blocks. Is enough for an iron door? All right. And a button. Let's go secure our AFK spot. Let's go to sleep. What in the... three times on my way over here. Button. We need two buttons. Like a stone button. That scared me. We can't make a stone button. I don't have wood. I'm gonna get trapped in there. Plant any more trees. Make sure I get at least one of these saplings. Got a sapling. Clean this up a bit. You don't need the stairway anymore. Here and a button for the inside. And we've got our AFK spot and you see here we've got 68. Okay, you've got a couple points to spend. We can get to the rose gold axes now. That's cool. And if we get the swords, this will be faster. But in the meantime, just leveled up. Not sure where I want to spend that just yet. You can barely hear me? Is that just when they're being loud? I'll fix that for next time. I went, I took my whole system apart. So I kind of messed up with everything. All the sound settings, all the streaming settings, so I'm kind of just grateful that this is working after I packed up my computer and took it to the farm to do some work. But anyway, I think that's a great place to stop. We're already running a half an hour long of what I had planned. We've got our XP farm. Okay, the grinder is loud. Cool. So that I'll remember that for next time. So I think we're gonna quit there. We did not get started in create because we did not find andesite and we got distracted by that spawner. But we'll pick up there next time. Find some andesite so we can get going on create, and that'll be next week. So thanks everyone for joining. I appreciate it. Appreciate you guys being here chatting. Thanks again to C3PO, who's no longer here to hear that, but her moderating is much appreciated. Please check out Sticky Piston. Great hosting. Check out my YouTube channel, Jangro Games, on YouTube. And we'll see you next time.
Out of time on the Sticky Piston Trials? Then try a short-term 7-day server. Play everything found on the free trials with no countdown of doom. There's plenty of useful features, such as the click and play installer and world manager to enhance your server experience. Your 7-day hosting will automatically roll over to a monthly subscription until cancelled. Get maximum value with prices starting from $1.49, 99 pence, or a euro. What are you waiting for? Host your Minecraft party server today.